Welcome to yet another episode of Dramatics.
Please do like, share and subscribe my channel and don't forget to hit the bell icon. So today we'll be continuing with the transformation of sentences. So today we'll be doing tag questions. Now what do you mean by tag questions? Now we had studied in the previous episodes about changing a declarative sentence into an interrogative sentence. Now, question tag is also a mode that you can change a declarative sentence into an interrogative sentence. Now, what do you mean by a question tag? Question tag is a shortened question that we put at the end of a declarative sentence to confirm something. It becomes an interrogative sentence. For example, if I am writing, she is beautiful. Now your tag will be, isn't she? So this portion is called a tag question. This portion is called a tag question. Now we are putting it at the end of a declarative sentence to confirm something. So that portion is called a question. Now there are certain rules to form a question tag. Now you should know this. Tag consists of the helping verb that is in the question and the subject pronoun. These two things combine to form a tag. Now, the important thing is that whenever you have an affirmative sentence, the tag will be always be negative. And you have, when you have a negative sentence, the tag will be always be positive. So, affirmative sentence has a negative tag and a negative sentence has a positive tag. That's how it works. So when you have to write a tag, you need the helping verb and you need the subject pronoun. If it is a affirmative sentence, you have to put a not. So for example, if I am giving you, I am cute. If this is your question and you want to put a tag here, so here it is a affirmative sentence, so the tag will be negative. So what is your helping verb? Here the helping verb is am and not, and your subject pronoun is I. Okay, so am not, you don't use am not as a contracted form, you don't have a contracted form for am not, so you will be using aren't I. So put a comma there, aren't I, question mark. So for am, this is a declarative sentence, affirmative sentence, you have to change into negative, so it is am not. Am not doesn't have a contracted form, instead of that we use aren't. So aren't I, because I is the subject pronoun. So I am cute, aren't I. Then if they are playing, for this declarative, how you put a tag? They are playing, your helping verb is are, you take this are out. This is a affirmative sentence, you need a not, and your subject pronoun is they. Now you have to write the shortened form of are not, that's equal to aren't. So they are playing, comma, question mark. This is how the tag comes.
If I am taking a
negative sentence, for example, she was not reading. If your question is this, she was not reading, this sentence is a negative sentence. So obviously the tag will be a positive one. You need to use this helping verb. Put a comma there, was, and she is a subject pronoun, was she, question mark. This is how the negative sentence you put a tag. She was not reading, was she. So every affirmative sentence and every negative sentence has a tag. affirmative sentence will be having a negative tag, and a negative sentence will be having a positive tag. That's how tag works. So every time, whenever you are using not, you need to use a contracted form. Was not will be changing into wasn't, is not will be changing into isn't. Similarly, when you don't have a helping verb, you need to find the helping verb. She sings loudly. So here you don't have a helping verb, you need to split this. She does sing loudly, because it is a singular verb. So does and sing, this will be the you have to split this sings into does and sing. So when again now you have the helping verb, it is an affirmative sentence, so you will be having does and not, it changes into doesn't, and your it's she. So she does, she sings loudly, doesn't she. So whenever you are writing, so your answer will be she sings loudly, doesn't she. So this is how you form a tag when the helping verb is not there. Similarly, you can use so we work hard, so your helping verb here is do, so it is a, so it becomes don't we. They worked hard, so it is a past tense here, worked. So you know when the past tense comes, it is did and work. So did is the helping verb and it is positive sentence, so not will be coming, didn't they. So whenever you are using here, the pronoun will become, if it is a noun given there, you need to put a pronoun there. For example, her mother sings sweetly. Mother sings, you know, it sings with, it is doesn't. So her mother, you can use the pronoun she, doesn't she. Her mother sings sweetly, doesn't she. That's how you need to put the question tag.
We can see some of the negative sentences here.
She won't arrive today. So here again it is a negative sentence. Won't is will not. So whenever you are using a tag, the tag should be positive. So it will be will she, question mark. She won't arrive today, will she, because won't is will and not. She won't arrive today, will she. Now they weren't playing. Now weren't is were not, so your tag will be were they. This is how you form tags for negative sentences. So this is how you make a tag, but you have to always be careful. If there is a positive sentence, the tag will be negative with a not, and if it is a negative sentence, the tag will always be positive. Now the tag contains the helping verb and the subject pronoun. You have to be very careful, helping verb and the subject pronoun. The helping verb with not, the contracted form, you will be using for affirmative sentences. Question tags for imperative sentences. There are only two tags for imperative sentences, will you or won't you. That depends upon the way you are, the mood in which you are asking a question. For example, if I am giving you an order, open the door, and you have to put a tag here, open the door, will you. So this will you takes the place of please. Okay, will you open the door, will you. Otherwise, you can use this also. Open the door. Won't you? Since in the imperative sentences, you is implied there. You don't specifically write you there. But for the tag, you can use the word you. So, these two are the tags that will be coming under imperative sentence. Now, imperative sentence, you have one more thing, the suggestion. Let us go to the park. And here, if it is a suggestion, you will be using shall we. So, every time, these three things should be noted for imperative sentence. And that's all for what the question tag is all about. Thank you and bye.